Hello friends, this is the topic about antenna ranges. Here the various ranges have been measured for measuring the antenna parameters. The ranges are listed out here. There are totally 12 different antenna ranges for measuring various antenna parameters. Namely TEM cell, where TEM stands for transverse electromagnetic cell. GTEM cell, where G stands for gigahertz. Outdoor range, indoor range, reflection range, slant range, elevated range, compact range, anechoic chamber, near field range, ground range, radar cross section range. So there are 12 ranges listed out here. We'll see one by one. The first one is transverse electromagnetic cell. The construction is being shown here. So it is a rectangular coaxial transmission line. The very important thing to be considered for a coaxial transmission line is impedance matching between the ends. Because if there is an impedance mismatch, there are chances of reflecting back inside the coaxial cable. So both the ends of the coaxial transmission line is matched to the impedance of 50 ohms, and this is taken care. Here it allows electromagnetic energy only in transverse manner in order to overcome the electromagnetic interference during measurement, because the measurement is a very important parameter where the interference is totally avoided. Here the interference is avoided by managing the electromagnetic energy in transverse mode. The testing unit is the one which keeps antenna under test. It's placed in the rectangular portion between the bottom of the plate and the coaxial line. There is a path between there is a space between the coaxial line and the bottom. In between there is a rectangular section inside which you will keep antenna under test. Okay, the next thing is GTEM cell. The only difference between TEM and GTEM is in GTEM you can use for wide range of frequencies, maximum of gigahertz, and any dimension of antenna under test can be considered here. Here also the impedance is matched to 50 ohms of impedance. We'll move on to the next antenna range. Then this is the typical diagrammatic structure for GTEM cell, same as TEM cell. Only thing is any dimension of antenna under test is applicable here. The third range is outdoor range. From the name itself you get an idea that it uses antenna of any size since it is taken place in outdoor. The disadvantage is if you're taking then consideration of antenna parameter outside, you're supposed to influenced by electromagnetic interference from outside sources. You can't bring it into your control. The fourth one is indoor range. Here to overcome electromagnetic interference, you'll go for indoor where there is a protection shield to overcome the electromagnetic interference. And the disadvantage is space. Inside room or inside any chamber, the space is very limited. And you can't bring a large antennas inside for measurement. This is for indoor range. And talking about reflected range, here the height of transmitting antenna under test are chosen. Here you can't give any antenna and you can't take any transmitting antenna or any antenna under test. It is always fixed, it is always chosen in order to limit electromagnetic interference. It has a limitation that there is a chosen value of antenna under test and transmitting antenna in order to overcome interference. Next thing is slant range. So slant range is in sense you will have a antenna under test, I mean to which antenna the parameter must be measured is called antenna under test, that is fixed on the non-conducting tower in conducting tower and at a fixed height. Here the height is known to the one who is going to measure. And at that particular height, you are going to keep antenna under test. And the transmitting antenna is kept on the ground. So you can imagine an inclined line between the transmitting antenna and the conducting surface, non-conducting surface like a tower which holds antenna under test. So here, The thing to be taken care of is to avoid the reflections. Reflections must be avoided. So, the orientation of antenna on the ground should be in such a way that it gives maximum radiation in order to avoid any absorption, because ground is capable of absorbing also. Have to avoid that, and it has to be oriented in such a way that absorption is less. If you reduce the absorption, the radiation is maximum. That's what they mean. The next range is elevated range. So here it is applicable for very smooth terrains. Both the transmitting antenna and the test are kept on different towers at different heights, no problem, but still it has line of sight. I mean, both are on the same line, so different heights are not possible, different towers. Okay, so the range of measurement depends upon the tower height. If you want to increase the range, you can increase the height. I mean, it's directly proportional. The next thing is compact range. From the name itself, you can get an idea that very short range of measurement can be done. Here, the measurement of plane wavefront is applicable. In order to get a plane wavefront, you'll go for paraboloid. So, paraboloid is the one which converts spherical waves into plane wavefront. And now, you can use a paraboloid in between the transmitting and antenna and the test, so that the spherical waves are converted into plane wavefront. And that plane wavefront can be considered for antenna measurement. Anechoic chamber, it is anechoic means very compact, very served, it not much influenced, okay, which means it is indoor chamber. It is ideally suitable for very small antennas. The chamber consists of ceiling and floor filled with RF energy observers. The purpose of using observers in the ceiling and floor is in order to avoid the interference. If there is any chance of getting RF energy during the antenna measure parameter measurement, it may result in wrong value. So you have to observe the RF energy by using observers in the field and in the ceiling. The chamber is of rectangular shape so as to accommodate well the antennas inside. Next is real field range. So it is a short indoor test range for measuring the near field measurements. Here the data at the far field data can be converted analytically or numerically into for the measurement of near field. So this is the most growing field at nowadays and most recommended also, since any data can be converted analytically and numerically for near field range. Ground range is a one. Here the transmitting antenna is mounted above the surface, which acts like a mirror. So here surface is like a mirror. So mirror has a capability of reflection. So the surface is capable of reflecting the transmitting waves. But still, reflections will not reach antenna under test, because the orientation is done in such a way that reflection must not reach antenna under test. The advantage is tall towers are not required, because installation of tall towers, it's not always recommended. It results in complexities. So we'll go in such case, we'll go for ground range, making sure that the reflections must not reach antenna under test. The second thing is, the last one is radar cross section range. So it is actually done in outdoor ranges previously, but now it is brought into compact range, where instead of antenna under test, you will have a certain antenna kept as a target. So here the target antenna has the measurement of various parameters of target antenna has to be done here. Okay, but still there are disturbances created between the target and transmitting antenna, is polarization mismatching or any distance between those two. So care must be taken for polarization matching between the target and transmitting antenna, and separation between the transmitting antenna and receiving antenna. So if you does all those things, then you can get a proper exact measurement of antenna parameters. So these are all the 12 types we have listed here and explained briefly. And that's it. Thank you.